Right, people. So, till now what we saw was how to make a smear. We saw how to stain it. We saw what stain was used. And we saw one, what is the stain that was used? Leishman stain. And we said only one component there, which is methanol, which is going to fix. Okay? Now we will move on to study more about what we have said in detail. Are you ready? Yes. Now the word Leishman should bring something to your mind. Does it bring anything to your mind? Yes? Leishman is the name of the person, we see the picture here, obviously, who discovered the stain, who actually modified the stain. But doesn't it bring anything else to your mind? You haven't read about Leishman? Leishman? Leishmaniasis. Have you read about Leishmaniasis? What is that? Protozoan disorder. Name on the disease paper. Colloquially say Leishman is technical name. Leishmaniasis is technical name. Colloquially we say? Kala Azar. Have you read about Kala Azar? Now this guy who you see was a British doctor. What he did was, he took the spleen of deceased patients, cut them up, sliced them and put it under a microscope, and this is what he saw. These are the infective organisms in Kala Azar. He needed to use a stain. And he prepared a stain, actually modified a stain, which was already available. It was called Romanovsky stain. Name of another person who made the stain. All of these contain the same item. The right stain, Jimson stain, I told four stain names. Leishman stain, Romanovsky stain, right stain, Jimson stain. Everything contains the same thing. What? It contains eosin and methylene. Only two things. Histology la rendu color use pannuvingala pencil la adhe da one blue color one pink color, so you have two stains. So somebody asks you a question, what is the composition of Leishman stain? You will say eosin methylene blue and methyl. They will ask you what is the function of methyl alcohol, you know, fix it. What is the function of eosin?
Stain.
Stain. Obviously. What is the function of methylene blue?
Stain.
Stain. Okay. Obviously, next question comes. What? Eosin to stain? What? Methylene blue to stain? What? Tell you that? That means what? What eosin stains, methylene blue? Cannot stain. That is why we need something else. What methylene blue stains? Eosin will not and cannot stain. That is why we need two different dyes. Am I right? Now, you will be also remembering this disease called organism, which causes Leishmaniasis. The organism which causes Leishmaniasis. Leishmania? Donovani. When we learn that name, we think it is an organism, but actually it is a name coming from two people. One is Leishman, another is Donovan. This is the guy called Donovan. And what you see here is also the same organism. Can you see that? And he also worked and showed this. And that is why this organism is given that name, Leishmania Donovani. What you see here is Leishman Donovan bodies. Anyway, that is not our purpose or interest here. What is why I am telling this is another way to remember in exam that it is Leishman stain and eosin methylene blue. All this should come to your mind. Shall we move on? Okay, coming back again to Leishman stain, I said methyl alcohol, eosin, methylene. Already we know that. Now, we know the job of methyl alcohol. What is the job of eosin? Stain something. Stain what? Stain what? Cytoplasm. Okay. Methylene blue for one?
Nucleus.
Okay. Why do you say eosin stains cytoplasm and methylene blue stains nucleus? Sir, enna naga histology illa appo da sir varaiyum. Correct da na appo da varaiyum. But there's a reason behind it. Why methylene blue goes and sticks with the nucleus and eosin goes to the cytoplasm? Yes. Any idea? Okay, it comes from the nature of the dye. Okay, are you ready? Eosin is an acidic dye. Eosin is what? It's an acidic dye. So it will go and get attracted towards basic material, isn't it? Purida? Basic material. And in the contrary, methylene blue is a basic dye. It will go and stick to anything that is acidic in nature. Now we say methylene blue enga podu solra nucleus podu appo nucleus la enna irukna acid irukna enga iruka acid nucleic acid. What is nucleic acid la enna iruka acid deoxyribonucleic acid. Acid, we keep saying acid. Purida? That is why methylene blue wants to go to the. Now I will tell you some another story. We give a name eosinophil. Eosinophil. Apna enna artham? Phil. Apna enna? Hydrophilic. Loving. Eosinophil means what? Eosin. Loving. Eosinophil loves eosin. That is why it is called
eosinophil.
There are eosin pathing. Actually, there is something in the cytoplasm of the eosinophil which is highly basic. We call it major basic protein. Another? Basic protein. That is why it's basic. The cytoplasm of the eosinophil is what? Basic. That is why it attracts what? Acidic dye. What is acidic dye? Eosin. So that is the job of eosin and methylene blue. Methyl alcohol for fixing. Eosin is an acidic dye. It stains basic components. Methylene blue is a basic dye. It stains the. Now please look at this picture here. Can you all see the picture here? Yes or no? Look. Tell me what are the colors you see. You see? Blue. Good. Pink. Any other color do you see? Any other color? White. Where do you see white? Background. Forget about background. Okay. Center here. Okay. So you see shades of pink. You see shades of blue. But the two colors that you see are only green and black. Green and yellow. Pink and two green lapa. What is that? Pink and blue. Why you are seeing only pink and blue here? Because you have added eosin and methylene. What is that you see here?
This is your peripheral smear. This is the smear that you make and put under microscope and see.
Microscope kila paakumbodhu ipdi irukkanum. Irukum correct ah pannuvinga.
Ana adu paathinga rendu color dhaan theriyudhu. Color podumbodhu enna onnume theriyadhu.
Do you understand? Round round ah theriyum avladhu. You don't know whether it is RBC, whether it is WBC.
Do you follow what I say? Yes or no? What is this? You see something here. What is this? What is this? What is all this? These are your
RBCs. Very good. Excellent.
These are your red blood cells. How do you know they are red blood cells?
Circular, huh?
White? Biconcave. Do you see biconcave here? Do you see biconcave here? How do you know it is biconcave? Non-nucleated. Very good. Do you see it is non-nucleated? Yes or no? How do I know it is biconcave? You said it is biconcave. How do I know it is biconcave? Center it is? Pale. Theriyuda? Central pale irukku theriyuda? Sutti dark irukku theriyuda? Central pale irukku. Yeah, central pale irukku. Because it is biconcave. And the dark area enna adu? What is the dark area? What is it actually? And the RBC la sutti sauppa irukla pa adu enna adu pa? It is hemoglobin. You are right. RBC la vera enna irukum? Avana idha? Avane da. Therila? What you see is hemoglobin. And the hemoglobin density will be less in the center of the RBC. Yes or no? Why? Because it's concave. Depressed. You have to
follow that? Yes or no?
Yes.
Good. Okay, these are all WBCs. These are all RBCs, I'm sorry. These are all RBCs. What is this? What is this? What is all this? Huh? What are these?
WBCs. Very good. First, you should know to differentiate between RBC and
WBCs.
Can you differentiate? How do you know this is WBC?
It
is nucleated. Number one, very good. It is nucleated. Number two, many of them look bigger than the
RBCs.
Very good. Very good. So that tells you that you understood what been talking all this time. Okay. Now let us move on to discuss about the next part of the class. Okay, we have made the slide ready with the smear on it. Now we are going to put it under the microscope and see. Okay? In the microscope, there are many objectives. Which objective shall we put? Should we put in 5x? 10x? 40x? 100x? We put it under an objective where it is written?
Oil.
Paathingala? Microscope la oil immersion eluthi irukku paathinga, that will have a magnification of 100 times, because we are not only trying to see the WBC, we are also trying to see a granule in the cytoplasm of the WBC. Puridha na solradhu? You are looking for what? So you need very high magnification. Can anyone tell me why it is called oil immersion? With this I will complete the class, okay? And remaining will continue later. Why it is called oil immersion? Once I saw a student taking a bottle of oil and pouring it on the objective.
He just took the bottle and then he poured on the bottle. I asked, why are you doing that? When I joined here recently, you know, first time when I joined, I saw one student pouring, Yambal, sir, oil immersion, sir. Immerse pandrara, objective oil cooler. That is what we will think when I say oil immersion, but that is not what we do, okay? So please do not do that. Don't pour oil, microscopic oil, bath. Don't do that. Innoru student enna slide mela utra oil adhe bottle thiki slide mela utita enda oil immersion sir edukaga idu solrenna why don't do that. So what do I do, sir? You just keep one drop. Where do you keep the drop? On the slide. Paathingala illa last la or drop vechanga paathingala? Just keep one drop of oil on the slide. Why do you want to keep oil? Question number 1. Exam, this is the question there. Why should you keep oil? You know what students say? Sir, it is oil immersion, sir. So we should keep oil, sir.
அதான் கேக்குறான் எதுக்கு அது எழுதிருக்கே சார் ஆயில் ஆயில் வச்சாதான் சார் அது வேலை செய்யும்
wrong answer clarity okay good clarity is right answer but how oil creates clarity
அதுக்கு தான் பழங்காலத்துல சொன்னாங்களோ கண்ணை விளக்கெண்ணெய் விட்டுட்டு தேடுங்க ட்ரை பண்ணிருக்கீங்களா யாராவது கண்ணில் விளக்கெண்ணெய் போட்டு தேடுறதுக்கு கிளியரா தெரியுமா ஒன்றுமே தெரியாது
So first question is how does oil bring clarity okay you said clarity agree it's clarity microscope சின்னது oil clarity agree but how oil brings clarity question number 1 And what oil do you use? Velakkenna? Coconut? Parachute? Sunflower oil? Bike engine oil? Castor oil? Paste oil? What oil do we use? Anybody knows? The answer is... Okay, go find out, okay? Olive oil, no. Go find out what oil it is. First, find out why do you use oil. Second, what oil and why do you want specifically that oil? Why not use coconut oil? They will ask in exam, seriously. I asked this time, nobody answered. All those who answered passed last time itself. Those who did not answer haven't passed this time also. Anyway, point is learn these 2 points. Why specifically this oil? Okay? With that, we'll stop the class. Next class, we will discuss more. We'll have a practical demonstration too. Okay? Thank you very much.